Welcome to the Pencast video of exercise 6 of the module FIR filters. The difference equation which describes the input-output relation of an FIR filter is given by the following equation. Y of n is equal to x of n minus 2 times x n minus 1 plus 3 times x n minus 2 minus 4 x n minus 3 plus 2 x n minus 4. To draw the signal flow graph of this FIR filter. So what we should start off with is by creating our input, x of n, and by creating all the different versions, so all different delayed versions up to xn minus 4. So this is 1, so this one is delayed once, so this is xn minus 1, another delay, which leads to the signal xn minus 2, another delay, which leads to the signal xn minus 3, and then finally the last delay, which leads to the signal xn minus 4. So next up, we multiply the signals with weights given in difference equation. Our x of n is not multiplied, so we can just forward this one. Our xn minus 2 is multiplied with weight, so we draw the correct symbol and we multiplicate with 2. These signals, of course, get added by an adder. For the signal xn minus 2, this one is multiplied with a factor of 3. And also this one, of course, gets added to the total product. The signal xn minus 3 gets in its turn multiplied with minus 4, and of course gets added. And the signal xn minus 4 gets multiplied with a factor of 2 and gets added. And this total signal is of course our output y of n. For exercise b, determine the impulse response h of n of this FIR filter. The impulse response of a filter is simply its output y of n for the specific case, so for the case that our input x of n is equal to a delta pulse. So in this case, if we were to fill in h of n, which is y of n of course in this case, for the case that x of n is equal to a delta pulse, this would lead to the following impulse response: delta n minus 2 delta n minus 1 plus 3 delta n minus 2 minus 4 delta n minus 3 plus 2 delta n minus 4. So by simply interchanging the x of n by a delta of n, we can find its impulse response. For exercise C, use convolution to determine the output due to the input x of n is a delta n minus delta n minus 1 plus delta n minus 2. Plot the output sequence y of n for n on the domain from minus 3 to 10. So the equation we have for the convolution sum, so y of n is equal to the summation of from case equal to 0 to the length of our impulse response, which in this case reaches up to 4, so we have 5 different values of our impulse response, of h of k multiplied with x n minus k. So for the case that k is equal to 0, we have h of n, h of 0 times x of n. For the case that k is equal to 1, we have h of 1, x n minus 1. For the case that k is equal to 2, we of course have h of 2 times x n minus 2. And we can continue this on up till k is equal to 4. And then the last one, k is equal to 4. and minus 4. So, the value of h at the moment n is equal to 0, all those delta pulses, so these four, the last four, will also be simply equal to 0. The only delta pulse that actually exists is the first term of our impulse response. In this case, this delta pulse is equal to 1. Times our x of n, so 1 times delta n minus delta n minus 1 plus delta n minus 2. For the case k is equal to 1, what we have is only this delta pulse exists, which has a weight of minus 2. So we have minus 2 times x n minus 1. So our x n will be delayed once more. So we have delta pulse n minus 1 minus delta n minus 2 plus delta n minus 3. For the case that k is equal to 2, what we have is h of 2, only this term is not equal to 0 and has a weight of 3. So we have is plus 3 times xn minus 2. So we will delay our x of n now by 2 time instances. So x delta n minus 2 minus delta n minus 3 plus delta n minus 4. For the time instance k is equal to 3, we have only this part of our impulse response with a weight of minus 4. So we have minus 4 times delta n minus 3 minus delta n minus 4 plus delta n minus 5. And then of course for the case that k is equal to 4, we have a weight of 2, so plus 2 times delta n minus 4 minus delta n minus 5 plus delta n minus 6. So if you were to work this out correctly, what you'll end up with is an output of delta n minus 3 delta n minus 1 plus 4 plus 4 delta n minus 2 minus 9 delta n minus 3 plus 9 delta n minus 4 minus 6 delta n minus 5 plus 2 delta n minus 6. So the only thing left for us is to draw this in a spectrum from minus 3. So let's create a little bit more space. From minus 3 up to 10. So minus 3, 10. This is our n axis. And this is our y of n. So, at the time instance of 0, what we have is a value of 1. So we have 1. At the time instance of n is equal to 1, we have a weight of minus 3. Time instance, we have a time instance of 2, we have a weight of 4. At time instance of 3, we have a weight of minus 9. Time instance of 4, of course, we have a weight of 9. As we can see in our output, we have a weight of 9. At n is equal to 5, we have a weight of minus 6. And at time instance of n is equal to 6, we have a weight of 2. And for the rest, all the values are simply equal to 0.